So in this problem, we're going to find the general solution to this differential equation, dp dt equals 10 minus 2p. So we're going to do this via separation of variables. So the way we're going to do that is I'm going to basically cross multiply the dt, and that gives me dp equals 10 minus 2p dt. And what I notice is I have a p over here and a t over here. I don't want that. Separation of variables means I need to collect the variables on the same side. So I'm going to divide both sides by 10 minus 2p. So I get dp over 10 minus 2p equals dt. And then I'm going to take the antiderivative of both sides. Now here's where a lot of people make their mistake. On this left-hand side, they rush through this. Because initially, you just want to say, okay, well, it's natural log of the absolute value of 10 minus 2p. But there's one thing we got to remember. Now, think of the opposite direction. If we were taking the derivative of this, it'd be 1 over 10 minus 2p times the derivative of the inside, so times a negative 2. Well, we're going the opposite direction, so we have to divide by a negative 2. It's because it's a chain rule, because of that negative 2 right there. Right-hand side's a little easier. Antiderivative of dt is just t plus c. You only need a constant on one side because we'll absorb it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply both sides by a negative 2 to cancel that negative 2 out over here. So I have ln of 10 minus 2p equals negative 2t. And then I'm just going to absorb that constant and just call it plus C2, where C2 equals negative 2 times C. Okay, it's what's called absorbing a constant and just writing it as a single constant, because negative 2C is just a constant. Makes it just a little easier to deal with. Now, to get things out of the natural log, I'm going to make both sides exponents of E. And so I have 10 minus 2P equals e to the negative 2t plus c2 up in the exponent. But what we'll do is we'll absorb that into another constant and rewrite it as c3 e to the negative 2t. In this case, c3 equals e to the c2. So we're just absorbing a constant again. Last things I have to do is I'm going to subtract 10 from both sides. So I'm going to have negative 2p equals c3 e to the negative 2t minus 10. And then I'm going to divide both sides by negative 2. So p equals, I'm going to absorb the constant again, so call that c4, e to the negative 2t minus 5, where c4 equals c3 divided by 2. So we have just the one nice constant. It makes it a little easier to deal with when we have our initial condition. And there's our general solution to this differential equation.